Good morning. Oh no. What's this about? Happy birthday, Sherry. That's a man who knows how to cover his bases. He wants his house to be happy. Matt and Kathy, welcome on your anniversary today. Blessings, we will bless you. Anybody else with a birthday? Somebody said their wife had a birthday, right? Where is she? In the choir. Anybody else's birthday? Oh, where? They're looking. Dad's birthday, okay. Listen, it is everybody's birthday. It is the birthday of the church. It is the celebration of Pentecost. Every Christian church celebrates the coming of God's Holy Spirit, making all things new, and God makes you young again this day. Sign yourself, and very importantly, not only with the Creator in Jesus, but with the Holy Spirit. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. That grace and peace of God, Creator, that love for Jesus, and that the life-giving Spirit be with you always. Let us prepare to celebrate the day, the moments, God's presence here in community, at this table, in our scripture, in our song, in our love. Let us put aside our fears and worries. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
For the times when we thought we could make it alone, when we forgot the community, when we forgot others. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
On the occasions when we said no, when we should have said yes, when we said yes, when we should have said no. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy. Forgive, help us to forgive. Bring us all, brothers and sisters, to eternal life. Amen.
Glory to God.
Thank you.
Now, when I call you, don't all come up. I know you all feel new again and young this day, but I'm going to call forth boys and girls for Liturgy of the Word. Come on up. Come on, come on. Where are the boys and girls this morning? Thank goodness. I didn't think we had boys. Now they're all up early. Few girls here. I thought we just had girls in this church. We got boys, too. What's your name?
Natalie.
No, not you, dear. You're fast. You, what's your name?
Caleb.
Do you think you can carry the book? Can you lead all the people? Can you lead all the boys and girls? I picked the smallest one, right? Now, learn about the Holy Spirit. Go, lead them. Let us pray. It was the Spirit of the Lord that filled the whole world, that contains everything and understands what is said. O God, who by mystery of today's great feast sanctify that whole church in every nation, in every people. Pour out the gifts of the Holy Spirit across the face of the earth, and with the divine grace that was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, fill now once more the hearts of your believers. We ask and pray in the risen one, Jesus, living and reigning in unity with the Holy Spirit, one forever and ever.
A proclamation from the Acts of the Apostles. When the day of Pentecost came, it found the disciples gathered together in one place. Suddenly, from up in the sky, there came a rush like a strong driving wind, which filled the house where they were seated. Tongues as of fire appeared, which parted and came to rest on each of them. All were filled with the Holy Spirit. They began to express themselves in foreign tongues and made bold proclamations as the Spirit prompted them.
Spirit,
They ask in utter amazement, "Are not all of these who are speaking Galileans? How is it that each of us hears them in our own language? We live in Mesopotamia, Judea, and Cappadocia, Pontus, the province of Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt, and the regions of Libya around Cyrene. There are even visitors from Rome, all Jews, and those who have come over to Judaism, Cretans and Arabs too. Yet each of us hears them speaking in our own language about the marvels God has accomplished." Of the Lord.
A proclamation from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Sisters and brothers, no one can say Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. There are different kinds of spiritual gifts, but the same Spirit. There are different forms of service, but the same Lord. There are different workings, but the same God who produces all of them in everyone. To each individual, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for some benefit. As a body is one, though it has many parts, and all the parts of the body, though many, are one body. So also Christ. For in one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, slaves or free persons, and we were all given to drink of one Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the evening of the first day of the week, and when the doors were locked where the disciples were out of fear, Jesus came and stood in their midst to say, "Peace be with you." Saying this, he showed them his hands and his side, and the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them once again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." Saying this, he breathed on them to say, "Receive the Holy Spirit. whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and those whose sins you retain are retained. This is the good news of the Lord. So nice to have so many young people read up here. Young. Forever. Well, we've listed the birthdays. We're going to celebrate and bless an anniversary of 50 years for Matt and Kathy. You and I are made new again, born again in the Holy Spirit, this Pentecost morning. Young men and women are graduating from school. People are traveling, the sun is shining. Anybody here this morning from out of state? Anybody not from Wisconsin here this morning? Where? From where? California. Last night it was Ohio. You have come the farthest. Anybody from out of country? And what brought you here? Visiting? Ah, family. Family brings us here. Family brings us together. Family makes us one, making us willing to travel all the way across country. There are two different accounts today of the coming of the Holy Spirit. One, Jesus was present at. And that reminds us of what? His breathing on them. Any Old Testament reference? Genesis. God formed us from the clay of the earth. And then from the elements of the earth, He breathed into us life. And Jesus, overcoming their locked doors, overcoming their fears, comes to the apostles in the upper room where they're shaking in their boots. And he says, peace, peace. Peace over and over again, and he breathes on them and says, receive life, receive the Holy Spirit. When I was young, I found it very difficult to get my hands on the Holy Spirit. How can you get your hands on a spirit? Duh, Dennis. But as time has passed, I've found it much easier because I recognize the Spirit of God where? In others. I look in the mirror, I don't see it. I see it when we're together like this. Oh, you know, it's more than wisdom. It's more than understanding. It's more than those seven gifts of the Holy Spirit that the bishops invoke and oil our young men and women with in confirmation. Realize that in the early church, they went to places and they said, they already have the Holy Spirit, and they haven't even been baptized. Wow. So the Holy Spirit doesn't conform itself to our rubrics, doesn't limit itself to just the Catholics. But all of God's people. One of the greatest displays of the Holy Spirit, I think, was this past Good Friday when the pastors, male and female, of the churches of this area got together and celebrated the redeeming death of Jesus. How powerful was that? Yes, the Holy Spirit is dance. The Holy Spirit is music. The Holy Spirit is concord. The Holy Spirit is dynamic. Every adjective of affirmation that you can think of is a display of the Holy Spirit. I think we ought to have them shake those flames. Is that what they are? Oh, flames and doves. Okay. Through the whole service. In fact, they can put one by Ray and me up here. Very comforting. I wish to ask, can I use those poles when they're not being used for flames and doves? They look like they're great limber sticks for fishing. We have much to be grateful for. That the Holy Spirit is gratitude. But you know, one of the greatest differentiating things you hear is that reading from 1 Corinthians that was proclaimed. It is not about individual. It is not about me. It is not about I did it myself. The gift and the Holy Spirit is for, as it says in another translation, not this one, the common good. The common good. Not my good, but the common good. The Holy Spirit is dynamic. Innovative, recreative. Again, I think I would give a homework assignment to people to go and look up every positive adjective and adverb that they could find. And verb, because it's active. That is God. It is not about death. It is not about war. It is not about arrogance or selfishness or pride. It's all of the positives.
We come in here this morning, and it's just real easy to get the Holy Spirit on a day like today, when the sun is shining. We're feeling all new again, when the thrift sale is over, and they're aching, but a good aching, because you brought all these things that we could recycle, and then you took home as much. God is goodness. God is love. Those theological virtues. But way beyond that, way beyond that, beyond our understanding, it says, the only thing that we have to really worry about, said Jesus, is that we would give death to the Spirit, that we would have an obtuse nature, that we would work against the Holy Spirit. And if you catch yourself in the negative, perhaps that should be your prayer. I wanted to say a lot of things, and a lot of things were racing through my head this morning, and I think I said everything I'm going to say. Because it can't be captured by semantics, words. It's life. It's God. It's the Holy Spirit. It is around us and with us. But so often can only be seen by our senses as reflections on the face of others. How can you not be renewed and life-giving when you see all these boys and girls come up here? The little one carrying the book this morning, and the old ones being blessed. For the common good, we make our prayers one. For the common good, we share the cup. We share the bread. We transport that bread to others. And it transcends time. It transcends our world. It transcends the ages. All things new again in the Holy Spirit. Oh, that it would be given to you over and over again. Send out your Spirit. Renew the face of this earth. Amen. Aware of that Spirit, then, we turn to our creed that now is on page 9. Not 11. I just memorized 11. Now it's on 9.
I believe in one God. Thank you. I look forward to the resurrection and life of the world to come. Amen.
O Lord, may our prayers resonate in each heart here for the common good.
Our response will be, Come, Holy Spirit. Upon the church and those charged with making decisions that affect others, church leaders, government leaders, business and media, we pray. Upon those having the courage and vision to share with others, we pray. For the poor, the lonely, the hungry, the homeless, especially poor children, we pray. Upon the sick and suffering, the homebound and hospitalized, and all the prayers in our Book of Intentions, we pray. For those dedicated to peace, Red Cross workers, Peace Corps volunteers, and all military personnel, we pray. Upon all who gather here this day, may we see the beauty of the world around us, the loveliness of each person we meet, the divine in everything created by God, we pray. Upon the dying and all who grieve the loss of someone dear, for Linda Lipinski, who recently died, and especially Doris Smith and Vivian Sherman, for whom this Eucharist is offered, we pray.
O Spirit of God, then hear our thoughts, our intentions. Bring life to all of the citizens of the universe, and especially your faithful, that they are renewed. Grant what we seek in the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Please join us in our presentation song on page 14, You Make All Things New.
offer that this be acceptable by the Lord. We pray, as promised by Jesus, the Holy Spirit may reveal to us more abundantly the hidden mystery of what we offer, graciously lead us to all truth. Grant this in the Lord. And the Lord is with you. Lift your hearts. Give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right, it is just, it is our responsibility to give you thanks, for you are the Almighty, you are the Eternal. The Paschal mystery of Easter is complete. The Holy Spirit is here on those you make your own, uniting them in Jesus. That same Spirit that brings our church to birth, opening to all peoples the knowledge of God, bringing together from the Tower of Babel oneness and understanding from the many languages, a profession of faith that is one. Every land and people would exalt, and the heavenly powers and the angels we would join with. Created gives praise. Through Jesus, by working and power of the Holy Spirit, to give life to all and to make everything holy, to not cease to gather the people. From the rising sun of morning to its setting, our offering is made to you, O God. We ask, the same Spirit make holy these gifts for consecration. Let these become body and blood of Jesus. Taking the bread, giving thanks, saying blessing, handing it on, take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, taking the wine, giving thanks, handing it on to his disciples, take this, all of you. Drink from it. This is chalice of my blood, blood of new and everlasting covenant. This is poured out for you and many so that sin is forgiven. Do this in memory of me.
The mystery of faith.
This is the memorial of the Passion of Jesus, a wondrous resurrection and ascension. What is offered in thanksgiving is holy and living. This offering of the church, the one we recognize by whose death you willed all to be reconciled. We then are nourished by body and blood of Jesus. We are filled with the Spirit. We are one in body and spirit in the Lord to make an eternal offering, to gain the inheritance of the elect, that we would join with Mary, Mother of God, that we would join with James, your apostle, our namesake, that we would join with all saints and angels. We rely on them for help and grace. May this offering advance peace and salvation for the world, confirm in faith and charity your forming church still on this earth. Your servant, Francis, our Pope, his representative here, Jerome, all those who serve the people. Listen graciously to the prayers of our family. We are summoned before you in compassion. Gather the children that are scattered through our world. We pray for our departed, for they live. They were pleasing to you, that they enjoy the inheritance in Christ the Lord, through whom you bestow all good on this world. It is through Christ, with Christ and in Christ, that in unity with the Holy Spirit, glory and honor belongs to you, O God, forever and ever. Peace I give to you, peace is what I leave always. Look not on our faults, our faith. Give to them each peace and unity now and forever. Amen. Peace be with you today. Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. O blessed are you called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
body and blood of Jesus, bring us all to eternal life.
Amen.
Talking to one of the Eucharistic ministers and saying it takes a lot of hands to feed this crowd. But we're never finished when we do one service here. It's incomplete unless we make sure everyone who wishes to be fed and can't be here are fed. Anybody bringing communion to somebody today?
Dad's okay? He's doing okay? Is he home? Do we have enough? Always enough. Oh, that as you would bring God to others, that the Holy Spirit be given them, that is life. That is hope, and that is love. And thank you for making the journey, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Fifty years ago, when you jumped over the broom, you didn't have children, and you didn't have grandchildren. Today they accompanied you. O holy God, maker of the world, you create woman and man in your image. You will that their union be crowned with blessing. We beseech for Kathy and for Matt, who today celebrate 50 years of their love. Abundant blessing upon them. Holy Spirit, accompany them. They live the gift of matrimony. They are surrounded by family. Praising you, Lord. Any sorrows you have seen them through, any joys, they know you are near now, that you comfort them, that they pray in this assembly, that they bear witness, and that they would both come in happiness to the kingdom of God. Amen. Amen. Thank you.
We only have 50 announcements, so hang on. I'm just kidding. Next weekend, the Knights of Columbus will have the aluminum can trailer here. All proceeds go toward this year's summer mission trip for the youth. The thrift sale, again, was once a great success. However, we still have so many nice things. You're invited to walk through all the departments after Mass and pick up what you would like. Hours for shopping are Sunday after the 8:15 Mass until 10:15 and after the 10:30 until 1. A free donation will be accepted and appreciated. Please stay for fellowship to visit with our fellow parishioners and enjoy some tasty treats before you shop. As always, for more information about activities here at St. James, check out the bulletin, website, and Facebook. Thank you.
Father Dennis, reverse collection.
Oh, yes, Father Dennis forgot one thing. We have a raffle of reverse collection for what the pantries need. And so please, we need the ushers to take care of that before we do final prayer. Be kind and generous. Take a number. Bring a can of corn. Bring mac and cheese. Bring pasta. Don't bring beets. I have a thing against beets. And that's all I'm going to say. Now we may stand. Bestow heaven upon the church. Safeguard the grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit poured out upon her to retain in all force this spiritual food, to gain her abundance of eternal redemption. Grant this in the Lord. Amen. God is with you. See God in each other, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Go from here in peace and serve the Lord and your neighbors.
And as we go make a difference, let us turn to page 25, and then keep your finger in 18 and 19 if you wish, and keep the spirit of alive after that song.